Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Zaino with 15 Minute Fuel. We're just in 15 minutes a day. We're going to fuel your mind, your body, and your future. All right, when everybody's getting on, I'll just go with the announcements. So, episode 31 of We Are Heroes is live. You'll see, probably you'll click on below if you're watching this, you'll see, make sure you go to our YouTube channel, our Facebook, Dr. Zaino fan page to watch that. Make sure you watch it, share it, post on it, comment it, and keep the engagement going. Also, for 15 Minute Fuels, make sure you're signed up with all our social media. So we're on Twitter, we're on Instagram, we're on Facebook, of course, we're on YouTube, we're on SoundCloud, Stitcher, iTunes, Snapchat. It's all under Dr. Zaino, D-R-Z-A-I-N-O. You type that in under search and you'll see me. Get a, you know, join the group. And also what I'm doing now, uniquely, if you're on Snapchat or if you're on Twitter, if you direct message me or private message me on those, I'll actually give you a video message back. You know, so I'll answer the messages through video. So anything you want to talk about, just let me know and we'll engage in that way. Let your friends and family know if they have the questions, they can reach me there as well. Same thing, your comments, everything, you can private message me if there's something you don't want to share on here, and we'll handle it. All right, so thank you so much. Make sure you give me the thumbs up, the hearts, the share, and let us know who's watching as well, where you're from, and any questions you have. All right? Great, so episode 31 was great. And in episode 31, we go over, it just shows you, I enjoy the episode because you're showing you that, you know, crap happens, you know. Not everything goes perfectly. So this one, you know, the place we did our dinners at, they got bought out and they closed the doors. And so then we moved to Tommy Bahamas. And then we went to Tommy Bahamas and the first time it was very noisy. And then we said, because there's speakers coming in, pumping, you know, music in the restaurant. So we did it the first time. What do? We learn from it. Okay, this is what has to change. The second time they didn't listen, so they're pumping speakers in, and then like the audience is getting frustrated, and I'm trying to stay on point, and it was just kind of it was one of those moments. So you get to see the after effects of that, and then we actually did move from there, if you want to know the end of the story. So we left Tommy Bahamas, and now we're at this Hubble and Hudson Bistro. It's like a total date night that all my boys love, and Whitney and I go there for Christmas, and so we're doing it there. So that's, you know, we went to our third place, but we're not going to stop. We'll make sure we do whatever it takes to get the message out. So please enjoy that. You'll love it. And we'll go from there. All right. So today we're going to talk about, I had someone from England, someone actually from London, England, contact me and said, if you could talk to your 20-year-old self, what would you tell them? I thought that was a great question. And the reason why, and it reminded me of a concept I like to, when I, you know, do masterminds with doctors and people, there's an actual coaching technique I use, or a mastermind technique called the time machine. And the time machine is, we use this in order to move forward. And there was two things that reminded me of this. Number one, it was this person from London who asked that question. And it was yesterday when I was talking with Justice. And he, you know, I'm like, weren't you nervous? Because he had to do this recital and he had to do these things in like 2 days. He was, you know, he got ready in 2 days. And when his answer was unique, it was one of no limited beliefs. He goes, well, I mean, I've been in this situation before. You know, I had to get a deadline done, and I did it before. So what makes this any different? Because sometimes that next thing, that goal that we're going for, we tend to see it as brand new, which I still think it is brand new, but he looked at it like David fought Goliath. So when David fought Goliath, here's this huge Philistine, this giant, and everybody's scared of him. And they want David to wear all this armor and do this stuff. But see, but David, the young kid, he's like, well, he is a big dude, all right? And he is an obstacle I got to get through. But then he said, but you know what? When I was farming, you know, when I was being raised and taking care of the cattle and the sheep, you know, I killed a lion. I had to fight a bear. I had to, you know, get rid of predators. No different than this. This is just another obstacle I got to get through. So because I did in the past, I could do it with this guy right here. And he did it with a slingshot, no armor, and 3 stones. And so you're thinking, wow, you know, that's the way my son was thinking. I thought, wow, you know, he's right. So when we do have something in front of us, we think about how big it is or what we have to get through, but we don't say, hey, you know what? I've been through this circumstance before. It might have been slightly different, but I got through it. So this is the concept of the time machine. If you're worried about something in the future, whatever it is right now, well, I don't know what I'm going to do in 5 years from now or in 10 years from now. Let's say it's that. Or I'm on this journey I'm going to go through. What you do is you go back. So say, okay, so for me, you know, I can only tell you through my story. go back to when Whitney and I first met. So if I was to go back 13 years or 14 years ago and meet my 26-year-old self, and Whitney was probably 24 or 23, 24, what would I tell them? I would look at them and I would say, I would put my hand on it, because now you're thinking, just think of in the last 13, 14 years, all the stuff that happened, the good times, the rough times, so you understand that all. But looking back, now, I wouldn't want any of those things to change, right? So the good times, the bad times, and all those unknowns built the stage to where I am right now. And you look back going, I wouldn't change a thing. So what do I do? I would say to Chris and Whitney, I would say, listen, I appreciate you guys. I know you, because I remember we were scared. We didn't know what was going to happen 10 years from that date. We didn't know what it was going to be like. How was our marriage going to be? Where are we going to practice? We had no idea. And I would just put my hand on my shoulder and Whitney's shoulder and say, listen, you guys are great. Thank you for being, faithful. Thank you for being, just totally being driven and staying together and putting your heads together and absorbing the shocks and the blows and staying, staying the path to get where you need to be. I would literally thank them for the journey they're about to go through. But the punchline of it all is I wouldn't tell them to change a thing. And I wouldn't even let them in on what would happen. See, that's the thing. If I met myself 10 years ago, I wouldn't tell them where I am right now. I wouldn't tell them that, by the way, Chris, you're going to have to fight a life-threatening terminal disease. Hey, Whitney, you're going to see your husband go down the tubes. Hey, guys, you're going to start a practice and you're not going to know anybody. And you're going to work and all these things, and you have no clue how you're going to get new patients. And then again, and by the way, probably in 5 years, you're going to have the largest clinic in the history of the profession. And you're going to have all these people, thousands of people that you, Chris, will have to personally adjust. And then it would be so heavy to know what the future held that that's why I wouldn't tell myself. All I would say was, listen, you're going to do great. Don't worry about it. And just keep moving forward and learn through the journey. And even though I would ask myself, but what's the future? What's the future like? I would say, if I told you, you would probably freak out. So just enjoy the journey, the good and the bad. And so now if I'm standing here now at 40 thinking, well, what's my next 10 years going to be like? Then you take that same principle. So if I would tell myself that at 20, the 50-year-old version of me, if that 50-year-old version came back, he would put his hand on my shoulder and say, Chris, I appreciate you for being faithful, driven, focused. Thank you for going and allowing the journey to happen, impacting people's lives that you had, and allowing life to take you where you need to be. And you're going to do more than you ever dreamed possible. So that's what my 50-year-old version would say to me, because that's what my 40-year-old version would say to my 20-year-old version. So that's when you start to move forward in whatever it is you want to do, whatever, adventure, endeavor, relationship, business you want to do, and you're worried about the future, you're worried about the unknowns, what it's going to look like, because you want to know the end of the book. You want to go to the end of the book and read it. Justice is so funny. Like, if he goes on Netflix, let's say there's a series of Transformers, the videos, right? He'll go all the way to the end episode, watch the end episode, and literally he wants to know the end. He wants to know the end of the story, and then he'll watch it. He always wants to know the end. He looks at books and he reads the end of it. What's the last page say? So then he could enjoy the journey knowing, hey, it's going to end up like this. But in life, even though we want to know the end, the best is the journey of it, the unknowns, the relationships that are met. The things, when opportunity and preparation meets and magic happens, the audibles, all the things that happen that you couldn't plan. That's why, looking back, I would tell them, hey, as crazy as things are going to get, it all works out in amazing ways. And, the 50-year-old, the 60-year-old version of me would say the same thing. And probably part of your verbiage would be like, there's no regrets. So I wouldn't want to change a thing, because if you did change something, maybe it would have turned out the way it did. So just think about it. So do that time machine exercise with yourself. If you're worried about the future, go back to yourself 10 years ago when you didn't know all the stuff you knew now. You're not in the position you are now. And then ask yourself, what would you tell yourself 10 years ago? Yeah, you might tell yourself to be wise here and not make this decision, but a lot of times the mistakes Whitney and I made were actually the blessings in disguise. It actually shifted us, punched us in the face hard enough to make us wake up and realize and make the shift to take us to a new, a higher level. Like I tell you that one time we lost a lot of money because we just gave it to a day trader. that wasn't too smart of us, right? That was kind of, you know, but we learned. We learned from tuition, but it allowed us to ask, well, how can I add value to other people's lives? So we became value-driven, not scarcity-minded. So no matter what, the good times, the bad times, it all was good. And so that's why when you look back and you would, what would you tell yourself 10 years ago? Then just imagine 10 years from now, what do you think that person, what would you say your 10-year-old now self, what would they say to you? It would probably be something along the same lines. It would come across as wisdom, wise, not too much info. You would probably encourage yourself, say, just stay the course. Hey, some big stuff's going to happen. Of course, someone's going to die. Someone close to you is going to break your heart. You're going to have a job change. This is all going to happen. So, like, you might go through some hell, but enjoy the journey, stay the course, and it's all going to turn out all right. So the punchline is, it's always going to turn out all right, because it depends how you react to the situation. So don't let fear and perfectionism and knowing, having to know the end of the story interfere with you moving forward. Remember, it doesn't matter the end of story. You know, don't be a perfectionist. You want to be a potentialist. And hopefully you've been watching the We Are Heroes series. We're at episode 31. You could see the journey. Binge on it one day and watch it from the first episode through now. You'll watch that like, I didn't have even an idea. I had an idea of the hero thing because that's what I was going through. I didn't have the idea of the keynote. You know, we went to Park City. We met Dr. Jim Temple and we kind of laid out and hashed it out. And then Roberta, we built the talk, not knowing where to go. And we got to speak here and there. And you get to really see the unknowns. And it's very beautiful because it's not a story. You get to actually see it documented. And I do that for one reason. I do it so it leaves the blueprint for you to see like, hey, there is not luck involved. You know, there is unknowns. The most known is the unknown. And then if he could do it, then I could do it, right? That's what it's there for. And the reason why I do the show as well is it keeps me accountable. If I'm saying something, I'm going for it. So this Wednesday coming up, you know, we're going to that Reach Academy Live, and I got 3 minutes. So when I work with Roberto, I'm like, we're going to do a 45-minute keynote, right? He's like, yeah, let's do it, because that's usually your keynote. And then Garrett's like, you'll have 20 minutes. And I'm like, 20 minutes? So to me, I was scared. It was like, I felt like 20 minutes, how long is it? It's like cutting off fingers and arms. And Roberto was like, yeah, the 20 minute is the hardest talk to do. And then I get an opportunity to speak this Wednesday, and they say you have 3 minutes, three. So 20 minutes, I was cutting off limbs, and 3 minutes, I'm like, you gotta be kidding me, right? You know, we got it. And then but the 3 minutes allowed us to really get it as focused, and it was so tough to do, but we enjoyed the process to get it to 3 minutes. And through that whole journey, you'll see that if you told me in the beginning, I'm gonna be speaking for 3 minutes on a topic, I would have freaked out, I would have got nervous, it would have been overwhelming, and I would have just shut it down. But because I'm accountable to you guys, accountability is so important, because I'm enjoying the journey, I'm taking the opportunities as they come, because if I do well, I was ready. If it doesn't go too well, it was a learning experience. So I take the opportunities, I make sure I prepare, and I move forward. I don't know the end of the story. I don't know the end of the chapter. I try to go, I pray, I try to look. Give me some insight. And I can't find the end of the story anywhere. So all I could do is keep reading the chapter that's one in front of the other. And then someday, I'll be able to look in the book and be able to look at the previous chapters and really see how everything was written as a masterpiece as it was created to be. So try the time machine exercise for yourself so you can move forward. What would you tell yourself 10 years ago? You know, what would be the words you would give them? And I guarantee the words that your future self would tell you would be encouraging, warming, loving, and telling you just keep moving forward and it's all worth it. Have an amazing day. So make sure you watch episode 31 of We Are Heroes. Make sure you share this because so many people would love to hear this. See, it's all a perspective change, isn't it? If you didn't see, I'm totally into time travel. And if you know, yeah, I love it. I love time travel movies because there's so much things you could do. So just think, going back in time, what would you tell your scared self? And you'd probably be encouraging. So guess what? If you're scared about something now, your future self would probably calm you down and tell you, don't worry about it. It's all going to be worth it. And it's all these little perception mind hacks that I do with myself to make sure I move forward so I don't get discouraged. Because I want to know the end of the story just like anybody else. I want to make sure the plan is exactly the way it should be, but that's just not the genius in action right there. So have an amazing day. Make sure you get to all our social media. Also, check out our awesome swag, all right? We have great shirts. Everybody loving the shirts. I'm getting so many cool pictures from everybody. So when you get your picture, I mean, when you get your shirt, make sure you take a picture, send it to me, or post it, tag me to it, and let's keep the revolution going. It is a movement. And so far, from you guys, the response has been life-changing. You know, I'm finding people finding the courage. People are finding their courage by pursuing careers according to their purpose. Like, you guys are literally pursuing different careers that's according to your purpose and hero. You know, the courage to heal and restore your families. I know many of you on here, you have your husband back again. You know, you have that man, that hero back, not because he just decided to be a man, it's because he's doing what he was created to do. And it's not a macho thing, it's living to the potential. There's so many powerful women now that are embracing their power, and they're saying, you know what, all of life, even the dogmatic teachings of school and religion, women really were never known to be powerful. They were never given that literally true place they deserved. And women are now embracing their power, and they're finding new hope and energy, and giving themselves permission to say, you know what, I am a hero. And you're proud of it. You know you can have some pride and ego with the humility that you always have, and you're doing great things. So just thank you guys so much for changing lives and sharing it and helping others. Have an amazing day, and we'll see you tomorrow with 15 Minute Fuel, which is in 15 minutes a day will fuel your mind, your body, and your future. God bless.